Redditors who work at Goodwill or other donation center resale shops. What is the weirdest, most disgusting, or nastiest things you've had someone try to donate? This happened to a friend of mine. As most people just throw their cloths in bags and drop them off to Goodwill, some douchebags decided that they should mix in a lot of crap with the clothes. So my friend goes to retrieve the clothes from the bag as he has done so many times before without looking and bam, basically reaches into a bag of moist feces. I thought you meant trash, not actual crap. Pee-soaked clothes were unfortunately common. Shotgun shells were found at least twice amongst clothing. I'm told a stick of dynamite was found once. A bag of dildos. Bags of actual trash. In high school, I would volunteer at a thrift store to get the service hours we needed each year. The store was run and staffed by a bunch of Protestant, conservative grandparents of kids who went to my high school. A bag of dildos. One of the ladies opened a purse and it was full of dildos. Another time someone donated a box of items that had belonged to their recently deceased son. Inside was a rainbow glass bong. In true naive grandparent style, a few of the ladies though it was gorgeous and filled it with flowers to put on display. Worked at Goodwill throughout high school. 1. A set of soiled dildos. They got thrown into a big box with other donations, including some clothes that had already been tagged and sold before the dildos were discovered. The health department had to come out and investigate. 2. A real, old military grenade. The bomb squad had to evacuate the whole store and neighboring businesses. They put it in one of those metal canisters where they try to detonate it, but they never told us if it actually blew up or not. The kind of people that shop there also make for plenty of interesting stories. 1. Someone donated one of those plastic igloos you put outside for dogs. A lady purchased it and we put a sold sign on it until she could pick it up. Another lady wanted to buy it, but wanted us to ignore that it was sold already. She got more and more angry and walked away. She later came back, crawled inside and took a dump, told us about it and quickly left. 2. We had this old lady that would come in every Sunday afternoon with a big empty purse. She would quickly walk to the back, stuff her purse with as many coffee mugs as she could, and run out. The cops would either show up too late or not come at all, and we weren't allowed to touch her. To my understanding, she still does this. It's been almost 10 years since I worked there. Chanel bag full of condoms. A bag of blood. Mason jar of someone's ashes. $4,000. Cash. Redirected to the police. Sterling silver penis. About 3 inches long. And bags of single socks. It baffles me. I did some work at a massive charity sale. We usually raised around 30-40k for the homeless. So it was a pretty big sale. The weirdest thing we ever got was an opened box of doucher bags. About half of the doucher bags were missing from the box. At least it wasn't a box of buttholes. I volunteer at a charity shop once a week. We've had crap-stained underwear donated, furry handcuffs and other sex toys. One of the weirdest things we got though was loads and loads of VHS tapes of pee. Seriously, like 20, 30 tapes maybe. They were mostly rubber and bondage stuff. A lot of them had a sci-fi theme. We just chucked them out. We also received some hentai DVDs from a different guy. The cover had a woman wrapped in tentacles covered in CM. That one has been under the counter for months now with a note on it that says "For Tom." During my time at Goodwill, I've had people donate the following things. Dog fetus. Authentic 18th century dueling pistols. Several bongs and a crack pipe. A cardboard box filled with 80s PVHS tapes. Someone posted pictures not long ago. Used underwear. Sex toys. Broken electrical goods. Sex toys. Pee. Bags of rubbish. Sex toys. Both of my cousins work at the Goodwill here in our hometown. The older one said that there is this one middle-aged lady who about every 6 months brings in a big haul of 3 garbage bags filled with clothes she collects from her family and extended family. That's really great, but there is always a plastic supermarket bag hidden in between layers of clothes with used underwear. I mean, they say they are always unwashed, stained and smelling used most times. She's been doing this for about 3 years. Twice a year, and there is always that one surprise they have to make sure they handle carefully into the garbage. What is her thought process, I always wonder? Gotta go to Goodwill this coming week. Also, that means new panties time. I'll just not wash and save them for them. Oh, and I'm sure some of you want to know how they know that they are hers. Bags are marked with tape, kids. Mine. Family. Her bags are the only ones with the used panties. I worked at a women's shelter for a while and sorted donations part of the time. We got used old lady underwear all the time. Unless it was in an opened, original packaging. It got pitched immediately. You've just had one of the worst days of your life. You cannot be expected to wear used panties. Just know. I worked in a thrift store this summer. Most everything was pretty okay, but there was a week where the worst crap would come in. I went through plenty of ripped up trash bags full of what seemed to be homeless prostitutes' clothing. Basically everything was crusty and smelled like pee and other unidentifiable awful things. Heels covered in crap. Straight up trash, and the creepiest blanket I have ever seen. Also included were 30-ish NES cartridges. What the frick? Where do people find these things? Why would you donate shoes covered in crap? These are my questions now, as I try to move on with life. Maybe they were trying to get their shits together but accidentally gave all their shoots away. It's not really disgusting, just sad and annoying. My parents used to work for a humanitarian group on the Navajo Indian Reservation near Gallup, NM. Churches from all over the country sent donations. Sometimes the stuff was really nice, sometimes not. They would throw out whatever they deemed unfit to hand out. The worst was a box containing half a pack of cigarettes, two sticks of gum, stained underwear, just thoughtless and uncaring stuff like that would show up about once a week. People like that are probably the ones who donate opened jars of musty spices, expired mayo and boxes of Jell-O dating back to 1988 to food pantries. When I volunteered at a food bank, I'd go through donations and pull out all the useless food. Just nasty. I used to volunteer at the local interval home. This one year near Christmas, this old couple donated this beautiful china cabinet. When I say beautiful, I mean absolutely gorgeous. So we get this butte all dusted off and we decided to take a look inside. I will never forget the stench that inhabited my nostrils that day. The odor was one that could completely wipe out the existence of a pack of vigorous orangutans, even at the smallest waft. There it was, a small plastic baby doll. Seems innocent enough, right? Number. Seeing as how this disgusting scent was coming only from a small plastic toy, we were mesmerized. We took the baby doll out, and my co-worker shakes it slightly. We hear a sloshing. What the frick? We cut off the baby's head and out spills a load of crap. Literally, watery diarrhea mixed with what could only be vomit. Freaking you. We sold the cabinet for $2,000. Joke's on them. They just bought the most disgusting air freshener they will ever have. TLDR. Never trust them old folkies. Fearful oh crap. By far the strangest I saw was a child-sized prosthetic leg, complete with wool sock and boot. Prosthetics are specially made to fit the user. The person donating it must have known this and that it would be useless. But we kept it in the back room for a while just because. Oh. Also lots of dildos. I did community service at a Goodwill a few years back. In 6 weekends I saw several dildos, at least 3 turds, and lots of other gross crap. I eventually worked my way into operating the large compactor in the back. They take all the undesirable clothing that is either too dated, or otherwise wouldn't sell, and compact them into huge 1,000 pounds bales that get shipped overseas to Africa. That's where the natives get Coca-Cola shirts. I hid stuff in every bale I made, like bowling balls, toys and once an entire television. One day a box of dildos came in and one of the kids up front brought it back to me, and we put it in the middle of a bale of clothing. TLDR. I shipped a box of dildos to Africa. Dear Africa. Get fricked. Live. 10 angry inches. At a food pantry I used to volunteer at, people donated all kinds of useless expired open food. An outstanding example was a 5 lb block of peppermint candy, opened and from the previous Christmas. I volunteer at a thrift store for a Christian rehab. Some of the strangeness I have found. Duffel bag with 3 mummified cats inside. Not nicely mummified either, all the runny bits drooled around the bag and dried. Didn't smell as bad as it sounds, so they were pretty old, but it still smelled pretty bad. A collection of animal penises preserved in lucite blocks. A fully functional copper still. Keep in mind, rehab. Several cases of uranium glass in excellent condition. Value, well over $6,000. A little more than a dozen seashell sculpture clam people. All engaging in various and probably anatomically impossible sexual acts. Keep in mind, Christian. More than 20 cases of booze over the years. Uncountable bongs, pipes, bags of drugs. Alive and very thirsty Pomeranian stuffed inside the inside jacket pocket of a suit. Enough pee to wallpaper a 3-story office building. Aggregate over time. 3 urns with relatives' ashes, not from the same house. Around $50,000 in 20s taped to the bottom of a chest of drawers and its matching dresser. Donated during a clean-out of a passed-away eccentric uncle. Family refused to accept the money back and just asked for a receipt. The creepiest anatomically correct ventriloquist dummy ever created. I wish I had kept pictures. Wait, no I don't. You deserve to sleep tonight. A full shipping pallet of expired Swedish fish. Still ate them and they were delicious. The candy, not the animal. Full ammo reloading kit with shells, lead, caps and about 200 rounds of finished ammo. I'm really disappointed that most of the top upvoted comments are just bags of dildos. I mean, seriously, how old are you people? Like 12? Hair-encrusted ball gags, bag of used sex toys books, dead animals. Maybe not the most interesting, but certainly the most disgusting. I've never worked at one, but this is sort of on topic. My wife and I were at a Goodwill, thrift shopping like it's going out of style, and I saw a piece of paper folded up into a small square with the name Tina written on the outside in permanent marker. It was tape closed. This, as we know, makes opening it a requirement. The letter was written in cursive, and kind of shaky, so we thought it was from an old person. It started out fine. The author, who is a she, revealed later on, was apologizing for paying her rent late. So we know it's from an old person. To her landlord. We continue on and it takes a turn for the weird. She begins to go into how I can't believe I am going to ask you this, tell you this, and prefacing the coming paragraphs. She continues to tell her landlord about how when she was younger, her older sister would treat her very mean, abuse her, and force her to watch as she gave her older brother oral sex. At this point my wife is telling me to stop reading and just throw it away, but that's not happening. She goes on to tell how this has made her not like people and not trust women, and that this is the reason her brother treats her so bad now. She then requests to have the landlord set up a hidden camera and try to lure her brother into a threesome with the landlord and the landlord's husband. She even has a script laid out. Not like, exactly laid out, but like, say something about oral sex, rub his chest, rub his legs, then sit on this side so I can see him. It was probably the creepiest thing I've ever come across. I considered saving it for a dit, but I decided to fold it back up and put it in a pair of shoes, making a fun surprise for someone and letting the legend of the Tina letter live on. Cracks knuckles frick yes. 2 years, 2 different locations, in 2 different parts of Canada. I'll just list some of the obvious stuff. Dildos and butt plugs. Used condoms once or twice. Yes. Used, mammy dolls, crap stained underwear, bullets, rotting food. One time we found a large green ham mixed in with someone's clothes. Used diapers, pee stained mattresses. People will just dump them at the donation area because they're too lazy and cheap to take it to the dump. Hilariously sexist romance books from the 20s. Heck, even new ones. All men are big burly super geniuses with billions of dollars and roguish good looks that want to settle down with a wife and have kids. And all the women are fresh out of a bad relationship, not looking for anything new unless the right guy comes by, that is. It's like P for old ladies. Does depressing count? Cause if so, I found a handwritten note folded inside a book that was written by a woman to her father. Basically, it sounds like she hadn't talked to her father in quite a few years due to his alcoholism and the abuse her and her brother suffered as children as a result. She talked about how she had attempted suicide at one point, and after years of being without a father she wanted to reach out to him to get him help as well and perhaps eventually patch things up again. I felt really dirty reading the note and folded it up and tossed it out. Those words were weren't meant for me or anyone else. I can only hope things worked out for them. Seriously though, what the frick is wrong with people who willingly donates used condoms or rotting food or crap stained underwear? And I don't mean I skid mark or two, I mean full on chocolate pudding in your pant kind of coverage. Do people think charitable organization are there to dispose of their trash? Is it a joke? I honestly don't get it, but I wish only the worst on those people, haha. Goodwill employee here. I've had people try to donate absolutely filthy outdoor toys, playhouse, a wagon. I've seen people donate a bug full of used thongs and G-strings. Got a comforter that was absolutely soaked and smelled like death. Something about wet fabric is just gross. The worst thing I've seen is a used condom among a bag of children's clothes. Thank God for rubber gloves. I hated people that brought in the dirty kids' toys, because a lot are really expensive and they can't understand why I won't accept the stuff and clean it myself. I worked at a children's consignment store for a few months. You know how sometimes your kid will have an explosive crap puke while you're out somewhere and you throw the diaper, outfit, and wipes all in the same bag so you can throw the whole thing away later? Make sure you throw it away, not mix it in with your clothing donations. It happened several times in the little bit of time I worked there. They changed their policy to include that clothes needed to be freshly laundered and not dropped off in trash bags. We constantly get lunch boxes, kids' school bags with half-eaten food still inside, and having to sort bras is pretty nasty, especially when there's sweat stains. I too volunteered at a thrift store for 2 years, every weekend, even after my community hours were finished. I did genuinely like it there. All the other old lady volunteers were friends of mine, but we did come across some pretty memorable donations. A garbage bag full of skid-marked underwear. This was hardly uncommon. People honestly believe thrift store shoppers are desperate enough to purchase their shit-stained underwear. Apparently, a yellowing bedpan. The best part is I live in a retirement community, so one of the other volunteers thought it would be worthwhile to sell it. And equally as alarming, someone bought it. Maternity bras crusted in sour breast milk, good god. I don't know. We'd always get boxes just chocker-blocked full of greasy McDonald's Opimio toys. Grossed me the frick out. Dude, Japanese businessmen pay hundreds for shit-stained panties. My friend used to work at Goodwill. There was once a small baggie of weed donated, with a super expensive vaporizer. Both were rescued. This thread is seriously making me consider going to work at Goodwill. Pair of children's trousers with blood soaked through the knees and blood splashed up them, like the child had been kneeling in blood. Old couple donated a gimp mask and a butt plug. Bag of wool covered in bird crap. So many skid marks in clothing. Worked at a local non-profit for 4 years. A lot of stuff was dirty and greasy and broken, but a couple of things that I remember were a baby shark in a jar of liquid and a box marked abortion meds. I had taken a pic of it, but it's on my old phone. I believe it came from Planned Parenthood. I found a jar of dog treats that had a pipe and a film canister with weed in it that had been buried in the dog treats. My boss took it home with him. Here I go. A suitcase completely filled with vomit. A box of 8 years worth of Playboys all completely hardened with love stains. Many penis pumps and stretchers of every size and shape imaginable. A bird cage from like the 1950s complete with corpse of bird. Will update if I remember anymore. A bird cage from like the 1950s complete with corpse of bird. Looks like I forgot to feed Polly for 60 years. After volunteering at a thrift shop for 2 years, I thought this thread was mine. Damn it. But the worst thing I can think of is only the occasional donation of unwashed, so worn that they're unsellable clothes. We just throw these straight into the trash and there's no problem. Instead we get a lot of cool stuff, especially clothing and books. So, Milburnians, from an insider's perspective, Ashburton Op Shop is pretty darn good. I worked at Goodwill for a summer a few years back, and one time this girl that looked to be in her mid-20s donated a bag of stuff. She was really nice, and before she left, she gave me a wink and said, "I hope those things go to good use, my co-worker," and I thanked her and began to sort it. When we opened it, we were greeted by possibly the most revolting scent I've ever encountered. In the bag, there were 5 dildos covered in a dry caramel-colored layer of crap and, what I assume, vaginal juices. Both me and my buddy throw up and instantly throw those things out. That's probably my worst story. TLDR. Cute girl donates crap covered dildos. My boyfriend works at the Salvation Army. He says every day people will leave bags of their garbage. I don't mean one man's trash, another man's treasure. I mean the same trash you haul to the road every week. Having said that, the weirdest thing that I can remember him telling me about was when he had to sort through a huge bin of donations and he came across dirty dinner plates with food still stuck to them. He's found many more weird and interesting things, but I can't remember them all. Used to work for the PVA, collecting items for a chain called Thrift Town. The most unusual items I've ever loaded into my truck had to be a lawnmower with half a tank of fuel, 50 king-size bed frames, local hotel was remodeling, an 80-gallon water heater. Yeah, no bag of dongs, I know. 200 blank cassettes, at least. That's the oddest thing I've seen. There is, however, a box labeled inappropriate in the back room that I have yet to look inside of. I'll get back to you later this week. I can verify that OP will deliver. I used to work for Goodwill in the book section. Two boxes stood out. One was a box filled with cabbage, and it wasn't rotten either. Second was a bunch of kids' books with an ant farm, but the ants were all dead. So basically, someone donated their dead ant farm. Rip ants. I used to sort donations to Toys for Tots while I was in the Marines. It's supposed to be donated toys for poor kids. We basically filled a standard gymnasium to about 7-8 feet deep with all the donations we got. We would sort them by age group and gender. I know gender roles, whatever, and distribute them to local non-profits, mostly churches. Mostly it was good stuff, even some really expensive toys, but I also saw steak knives, fireworks, canned vegetables, used clothes and some other weird crap. Bonus. We weren't allowed to distribute toy guns or weapons. Something about not wanting to appear to be militarizing America's poor youth. So we got to keep and play with all the Nerf guns. We had full-on, epic Nerf battles with complex ambushes and crap. Till, as awesome as Nerf toys are, do not donate them to Toys for Tots. A box of dead decapitated kittens. We called the police, and when the sick sucker came back to the store about a month later, we called the police and they picked the guy up. He later got convicted of some sort of cruelty animals charge. Freaking disgusting. I still remember their tiny little heads. My brother rented out a room in his house. When the tenant moved out, he left behind a bunch of his stuff, including a huge collection of freak pee. My brother just bagged it all off and donated it to ARC. I just started working at my local thrift store a month ago. We always get nasty clothes. But one time this couple donated stuff from one of their dads who has Alzheimer's, and there was a bag of crap it in a box with other goods. We can't sell that crap. My wife runs a thrift store, and I am actively involved in helping sort donations and put stuff out on the floor. We see everything. From crusty bedsheets and pillowcases to kids' clothes with poo stains. Not really gross, weird, nastiest, but definitely interesting. We got a garment bag full of men's suits one weekend. Nice suits. All of them were tailored. Beautifully made custom suits with Gucci and YSL tags in the inner pockets. Probably made by a tailor with YSL and Gucci fabric. Inside those breast pockets is what made these suits so special and memorable. We found business cards and note cards in almost every pocket, and not just any business cards. In every right-hand pocket were a few cards of the presumptive previous owner. They had a generic classic name, James A., Henry or John P., Forbes. I know the real name. These are close examples. Just a phone number, an international one, and that's it. In the other pocket were dozens of other biz cards and notepads with notes about places and times, sometimes names, nicknames. The biz cards in those pockets were written on too. Personality descriptions, physical traits, profile notes, etc. When I found these, my brain went nuts. I wanted to know who the F this guy is, and why he would leave these suits at a random thrift store, not a Goodwill or Salvation Army in a not so well known part of a city. With all this seemingly important information, I want to know who this guy was, and what he did. I know this is just fantasy to me, and I'm probably wrong, but these suits seem to belong to a spy or agent or intelligence official of some sort. Maybe he got out of the game and wanted to throw his crap away but leave this little trail behind. Maybe he got killed and the killer brought this stuff in. Maybe he's just a regular guy with a bad memory. Who knows? I'm slowly researching and trying unsuccessfully to put together the puzzle, hoping to one day get an answer. I worked at Goodwill during college. I was the guy who sorts through housewares and prices them and also accepted donations whenever needed. One time I got a box of dildos. Dildos? I've never had to pluralize dildo before, and I hope I never have to again. TLDR. Dildo box. I accepted the donations at a loading dock for a larger, department store style thrift store. One day a man approached with an entire pickup truck full of soiled clothing, reeking of urine. He told me that his wife had just died and that these were hers. He smelled of root vegetables. I threw the clothes out with a shovel. He smelled of root vegetables. What? If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.